There are so many built-in functions in Python that we can use. This one is actually a very useful one. We use it to sort different types of data structures if it is allowed by the format of that data structure. If you're a new viewer, welcome to my channel. And if you're returning, you know that I love teaching and I make it easy for you to understand how problems are solved. Yes, you can find the answer to this challenge in ChatGPT or other large language models, but here I'm actually showing you how to think about the problem and how to solve similar problems in the future. So if you're invited to an interview for a coding challenge, you might not see these type of problems and you might really need problem solving skills. So let's see what this one is about. Like every other video, I've got my Jupyter Lab on the right hand side. I've got the problem definition from the Hackerrank on the left hand side. This one is called Athlete Sort. It's a medium level of difficulty, but trust me, I'll make it so easy for you to understand. Let's hit the solve challenge. And as we start, you can see that a lot of the coding has been actually done for you. So you'll have to use these lines of the code and then continue from there. I'll first introduce what the task is. You will be given a table like the one in white. It will have a multiple number of columns and multiple number of rows. This is a table of some athletes and their age and their height and their rank and such and such. So the user will define what the table looks like. It can be only two columns and two rows, or it can be 10 columns and 100 rows. There might be some constraints from Hackerrank, but first, let me tell you what the input format is. The first line contains N and M separated by a space. For example, it will be 5 and 3. The next N lines each contain M elements. So you can have N lines with M elements. You can have 5 athletes with 3 attributes, their age, their height, and their score, for example. The last line contains K. So we will also be receiving a number called K, which in this case is number 1. Print the end lines of the sorted table. Each line should contain their space-separated elements. Check the sample below for clarity. So here is the task. You're given a spreadsheet that contains a list of N athletes. So we have N athletes and their details. And we have M number of details about them. Age, rank, height, whatsoever. You are required to sort the data based on the kth attribute. So here is an example. You've got the rank, age and height for 5 athletes. So rank number 1, age 32, height 190, and such and such. You are asked to receive a number under K, and K will define based on which column you sort this table. For example, here, K equals 1, right? We know that in Python, we start counting from 0. So 0 will be rank, and number 1 will be age. So I need to sort this table based on age, which means that I will have to go from younger to older, and all the table needs to reshuffle. So we've got the youngest person who is 24 years old, is in rank 5 and height 176. You can see that it's sitting up the top. Note that K is indexed from 0 to M minus 1. We know that in Python we count from 0. If two attributes are the same for different rows, for example, if two athletes are of the same age, print the row that appeared first in the input. That's also very important. If you've got two athletes that are 24 years old, you want to choose the one that was mentioned first in the original table to sit up the top, and the second person who is 24 years old after them. So we will be doing that. Now, let me help you with the input format. The first line contains N and M separated by a space. So you can see that I have received 5 and 3. Then the next 5 lines will be the table, which will be the number of athletes and their age, height, rank, whatever the user gives us. So that's the input format. And the last line contains K. You can see that K here is number 1. But the output is the sorted table. So once you do the sorting, you will print the table in a sorted format. So in order for me to solve this, what I will do, I will just ignore this if name part. I will make a video and I will leave the link up the top right to teach you what this line means. But for now, I will copy these lines and I will bring them to my Jupyter Lab. The reason I'm doing this is because I want to show you how we receive the input from the user. Let me just unindent these ones. They all have to be in the same line. I will show you what these lines do and then what do we need to write after these to be able to sort the table based on the requirement. So this first multiple input will take M and N from the user. So it will come through an input function. It will strip any unnecessary space before or after, and then split using the space between those numbers. Once it does that, it will assign the first one to n, and it will assign the second one to m. So now I have n and m. Now it's time for me to accept the user data per row and column. I will use an empty container if you like, and I will call it ARR for array. You can call it anything you want. This is only what Hackerrank wants it. And I will run a for loop that takes an input from the user, strips it from unnecessary spaces before and after, splits it into chunks, and then makes them an integer using the map function. I will leave a link to the video I have made on the map function, and then converts it into a list so that you've got a list for the first athlete, for the second athlete, and the third athlete. And then you keep dropping it into the bigger container as you get them from the user. Once you have all the details from the athlete, then you receive the K number, and that tells you based on which column you need to do the sorting. So let me run this, and I will copy the example from Hackerrank, and I will paste this into here so that I can show you what happens next. So let me make this a bit smaller, make this one a bit smaller. I will run this cell, and I will copy and paste these lines from Hackerrank. So 5 and 3, 123, 12, 6, 5, 9, and K is number 1. So let me extend this. So far, I haven't done any calculation on the task. It's only taking the input from the user. Now that I've got this user input, let me first quickly show you what ARR or the array shows you. This is pretty much the table that we have been talking about. So if I show you the table like this, you will see that it looks something like a table, if you like. All I need to do is to sort this based on the K column, which here happens to be column number 1. So this is column number 0. And this is column number 1, if you like. Before I find the solution to this problem, let's think about this. What are we expecting to see? Well, I'm expecting to see this one up the top because the second column is the smallest, right? And after this one, I'm expecting to see this one because number 2 is then greater than 1. And then I'm expecting to see this row. And then I'm expecting to see this row, right? And lastly, I'm expecting to see this row because I am sorting this based on the second value here. This looks to me as if it is sorted. So how do I do this in Python? Well, there is a built-in function called sorted. Sorted takes an iterable, like a list, like a set, and then uses some key to perform the sorting. So if you want to go from small to big, you just leave it as is. If you want to go from big to small, you will have to set this to be true. I'm not hoping to go from big to small, so I will not touch that one. So let's use sorted on an iterable, which is the array here, and I will be using a key. The key is actually very important because I'll be using a lambda function to perform the sorting on each row. This X here, if you like, is each of these rows in that bigger list. And I will be taking the first element, which is not the first element really, it's index 1, which means the second element. I will be taking the second element for sorting of the array. If I run this, you will see that I'm seeing exactly what I was expecting. I was expecting to see 710. That's here, 10 to 5, 6, 5, 9, 9, 9, 9, and 1, 23, and 12. So I think that's the right result. All I need to do is to copy this code onto Hackerrank. This part of the code came from Hackerrank anyways. All I need to do is to copy this one line and bring it here and paste it here and hope for the best. So go there and print this one. Let's see if it's going to work. I'm not sure if it will because the sample output has to be printed line by line. This is not printing line by line. This is printing them all together. So maybe I have to print it like this. For this in this, print this underscore. Maybe this is the right way, but when I look at the output doesn't have any square brackets. I need to get rid of those square brackets. How about if I leave a star here, you will see that those square brackets are now gone. So if you don't know what that star does, I have a video. I will leave a video and the link will be up the top right. So I think I've got my answer. I will copy this and I'll come back here, get rid of that line that I pasted here earlier, paste this one in, move my face to the left-hand side, run that code, and fingers crossed it will be successful. So first test case was successful. If I submit the code, all test cases should be correct. Yes, they are. So if you liked this video, hit the like button, leave me a comment, let me know what you think of other videos you want to see, and share it with your friends. That means a lot to me. Thank you.